All right, well, good morning. I'm still talking about the rampantness of the political push and ways they have maniacaled themselves to be such a continuing industry. I will firstly be an accuser to those who have lit wildfires across the United States, including Yellowstone National Park, that the agenda, the actual end agenda, was to timber those lands very cheaply. That was the agenda. So we have to look at any of the wildfires that have been set from Los Angeles all the way up the California coastline, all the way to the Grand Tetons. All of these are a helper for their industry. Okay. So I can't say that guy started the forest in Yellowstone National Park. I can't say that. But very possibly one of his minion group has, on purpose. And very possibly he's all for it. That person that's in that group of grove right now that's killing it. All right, I know, I'm like, well, what am I solving here today with video after video? What am I actually solving? It just looks like they're winning. They've impoverished so many Democrats that were liberal Democrats. They've impoverished us. So we really have very, very little voice to speak. We can not really hire lawyers. They've impoverished us so far. They have harassed us beyond belief. They've intimidated us beyond belief. When I'm in a neighborhood surrounded by lumberers, I am just something that they can kill through harassment and intimidation techniques. They're using all kinds of fun, like paranoia, that they've been wanting to push on me. And I'm like, well, no, it's not going to work. I'm sorry, I'm too strong for that. Way too strong. So I am just breathing here, you know, impoverished. And that's all right, you know, I'll take my vow of poverty, and my, but it hasn't helped, has it? To be impoverished, it has not helped, because I can't get that guy out of the tree. I can't. I apologize to the birds in this area. I apologize to the birds. I can't help you. The big push, you know, the big success story to who you are going to be, make your millions, you know. What was that all about, you know? All of you people are doing that. Sometimes I feel like the real people, the real ones, those, the good, I get the feeling that they did make those millions and they've been bilked. I get the feeling that that's all that's been going on here with this Republican group, with this over-religious group of politicians, including that presidential Democrat, Clinton. I didn't see him running around saving coastlines. I didn't see him doing any of that. I saw him just busy at a stupid war over there in Sarajevo. I saw him busy over there in Kosovo. I saw him busy over in Iran. I didn't see him busy here on our coastlines or any of our national forests. When we get to national forests, that's another thing we have to continue. We had Teddy Roosevelt. We have had many presidents that have made wonderful, wonderful clauses and statements and they've just written it down that these are protected zones, these are sanctuaries, and we have to keep up the act of looking at that paperwork and knowing when those dates, if they ever cease. Because then when you have a forest and you have a park that it had maybe a 60-year date or it had an 80-year date, we have to keep up that information to know when that park is up for grabs again. Because that's what they're looking at also. The enemy is looking at those parks just desperately, wanting them free now, wanting those Teddy Roosevelt mandates removed. Interesting that, yeah, he was kind of a cripple guy. Interesting that, well, gee whiz, I guess my environment of where I am sitting and standing all around me, when it is touched and when it is abused and when it is destroyed, when I can't hear the birds sing, I guess it really does affect you when you can barely walk. That was Teddy Roosevelt. So anyway, there were a few greats out there that did their job as an electorate that worked for the planet to continue instead of the planet to destroy. I don't know. The brain switch mechanism that wants destruction. I can't believe it. I cannot believe people have that path in their brain. I will allow that strange, odd argument for newer trees that have not been pruned correctly, that were allowed to grow in strange manners. I will allow that, you know, young trees that yeah, maybe they were not beautiful because they were pruned badly. But that becomes like, what? That's a free-for-all for everybody. I'm talking about when the tree is right at the bottom and it's grown out of its stump. And unfortunately, I think that happened to this tree on this corner here. That tree, I believe, is almost 250 years old that they cut down. And it did grow in a very bad predicament for many years. I mean, at some point, you just have to put up with it. You know, it's had too much animal species life and habitat. And used to, you know, that's their travel path, that's where they stop when they're traveling north to south. That's their used to. You can't take it away. Even if it's an ugly tree that was not pruned correctly. You know, you just can't take it away. Pruning them from the very beginning, when they are just 4 and 5 years old, that's it. That's all you have to do. Those early prunings. And once that's done, it's done. You have a straight tree, as best as it can go. You have a good full upper bouquet. That's all you need. A tree does not require any more than that. The wind handles the rest. Yeah, the wind. Now, when we're in this bonsai nation, more and more Asians have moved in. Well, I imagine they are now going, my gosh, the giant bonsais are being removed. Somebody is killing the giant bonsais. Anyway, how do we keep breathing in this situation where we don't get heart attacks? How do we keep our health? when we are under severe intimidation by non-ecological people? How do we remain calm? Giving great, like Dashik did. Dashik gave some great videos, didn't he? He was a good world helper. He was there for a good, 25 videos or so, and he really made an effort. Each one was a big pow, a big pow at this industrialized kill of the planet Earth. He really did try. My little words out here every day are just like a, just nothing. I'm not a great, director of video entertainment. But he was. He did it. He did touch, He did touch those little things, those wins that they've been winning with. He did touch it, didn't he? He was a non-afraid, and he's not around much, is he? Not around much, is he? Anyway. Is that what we're going to say at the end? As the lemming non-ecological destructors, destroyists, they push every tree off the edge of the coastline. Is that all we're going to say anyway? Nobody's pushing them. Why not? Why is nobody pushing them off the coastline? How come these lemmings have been allowed to destroy our air? Okay, I talk about them as the filters again. Yeah. They're fog filters. The fog rolls in. The fog rests. It settles. It works through the needles, the underbelly of the trees. The transpiration of the morning dew. It bounces back and forth between the tree branches, the trunk, and the forest floor. That bounce is a slow evaporation. It releases, this is all fresh air coming in from the ocean. It releases a slow evaporated, beautiful, yes, reoxygenated, again soil by the worms and the birds. It releases a beautiful air through their branches. And that beautiful air just glides over the mountains, and it just becomes wonderful fresh air for Bay Area people. And they say they have some of the cleanest air in the world. Well, that will be a change. That will be a change. You will not be able to have that statement any longer. All right. Yeah, look into those parks that maybe their Park Protection Act has a date end, a deadline. Look into those. State parks, national parks, all of them.